We have just experienced the disappearance of millions of people from the earth. Some are calling it the long-awaited rapture, which was touted by Christians and became a hot topic among many religions, as well as religious skeptics. Some are refuting this theory, citing the prediction of aliens capturing these people. This is a global emergency like none ever experienced in human history. As I see it, others as well, we just rid ourselves of the most controversial population of resistant and antiquated people ever to inhabit the earth. It's still early in the game, however, as this phenomenon cools, like other pandemics, and things are restored, we will finally be able to go on with our lives uninterrupted by those religious fools. Harry?
Well, Megan, as you can see, there are protests all over the world. People are frantic and others are desperately looking for their loved ones. We have never encountered such chaos and horror. I don't think we have a prayer. This may well be the end of humanity. We can't say we weren't warned. We just didn't trust those who were warning us. If there is a God, I hope he helps us all.
I don't want to meet with him, but if I don't, it will make matters worse. I'll schedule a Zoom call. It won't be wise for them to come here.
I called us together to help all of you to cope with what just happened, and to answer any questions or address the concerns you have.
Why are you still here? I thought you were ready to go to heaven. Why didn't you warn us? Why didn't you preach about the end when you knew it was near? Why?
I'm only here to help you. I already prayed to God for my soul. And he's going to deliver me from this mess. See, I'm special. I'm highly favored. I'm anointed, appointed, approved, and God will not allow me to go through this great tribulation that is coming.
Oh, so you get to go to heaven, and we have to go through impending damnation? And it's all your fault. You are nothing but a fake, no good, lying, cussing, drug addict. You fooled us into believing you were ordained by God to lead us to the truth.
Well, you should have gone somewhere else if you thought I was such a sinner leading you to hell. Look, all of you were foolish to put your trust in a man that couldn't save your soul. I'm a prophet of God, and I profited from you too. I guess you were too lazy to get to know Jesus for yourselves, and now you blame me for your loss? I'm done with all of you. Go burn in the lake of fire.
Our government is imposing a curfew. All citizens must be indoors by 8 p.m. If anyone is caught outside, they will be shot and left to die. No exceptions. Keep your children and pets inside. This curfew will not be lifted until an announcement is made by the World Regulating Authority. Our broadcast will end at 6:30 p.m. There will be no public transportation after 4 p.m. All stores, businesses, governmental offices, banks, and public places will be closed at 5 p.m. I repeat, our government is imposing a curfew. All citizens must be indoors by 8 p.m. If anyone is caught outside, they will be shot and left to die. No exceptions. Keep your children and pets inside. This curfew will not be lifted until an announcement is made by the World Regulating Authority. Our broadcast will end at 6:30 p.m. There will be no public transportation after 4 p.m. All stores, businesses, governmental offices, banks, and public places will be closed at 5 p.m.
Pastor, I have a few words for you. It was gross negligence on your part not to tell us that we need to repent of our sins. Your approach has cost me my soul. I never knew I was living in sin with my boyfriend. Your sermons just made us feel good. You thought you were uplifting us. You didn't want to make us feel bad about our wrongdoing. I hope you rot in hell. You are the weakest, most disgusting person I know. You had no right to lead us down the wrong path for the sake of staying in your lane, as you say. You're a weak, dull creature. And you will burn in hell with us all.
Well, I have a lot to say. I know all about you. Chandler told me what you did to her and several other people. The mere fact that you are left here with us proves you are not highly favored, anointed, appointed, and approved of God. In fact, you've caused so many to go to hell. Hell is your reward. I remember when you first started this church. You were nothing like what you are today. Nothing. You let power, money, and heavy tithers turn you away from your only help. I know. I'm going to hell, and you will be right there with me.